Just going into the 60th, the final day, my mindset is just the same as it always is. Just go there, execute the way I know how to, and hope for the best, honestly. And if it was meant for me to win, then I would win. And that's how I go through every race, really. He has a good start. I've known that for the last couple of years that we've competed against each other. And so I was expecting it, but I wasn't expecting it to be quite that good. And in the final, it just kind of took me out of surprise. And thinking about maybe 25 meters, he was still ahead of me, which forced me to react and get out of my drive phase. And I started trying to run, but he had held his to the point where there was really no coming back. And towards the finish, I think it was maybe like 5 meters out, I realized like I wasn't going to catch him. And so in the pictures you could see, I was probably smiling already. And I was like, yeah, he got me. And so I was just really, it was disappointing. I wanted to win, of course, win four in a row. That would be my ninth title. But at the same time, I was just so happy. Like seeing how happy he was honestly made me happy, because I remembered how I felt when I won my first one as a freshman. Going into the 200, I was upset about the 60, but it's just kind of like Coach Kev tells me, it's just one race at a time. So once that 60 was done, I had to get it out of my mind. Clear my head for the next race and go ahead and execute the best way I know how. And that's exactly what I did. In that 200, once the gun went off, it was kind of a no hold back type of thing. I wasn't gonna play with that title at all. There was no, oh yeah, he might have a good start. I didn't care about any of that. It was just, I have to win this race. And so coming down the home stretch, it was, something clicked in my mind where it was like, okay, now I gotta go, because I was a little bit behind on the turn. And once that straight hit away, I was like, I have to go, I have to win this, I need this. And winning that title, that one being my ninth, it was great. It's a good feeling knowing that. I mean, my goal is to get to 10. And so once I hit the ninth one, I was like, okay, one more to go. And then once the race was finished, I stood staring down the straightaway, and like I looked up and I was like, man, like this has been a crazy ride. That being my last individual race, just kind of reminiscing about everything else that had happened through the last couple of years. Once I saw them, my teammates running around, coming through, I was like, okay, got to get my mind ready, got to get my body ready so I can go ahead and do this, run for the guys and try to get this title in the 4x4. Hopefully that one would be my 10th one. And so that's what I did. I mean, I got the stick and I tried to go, with the shot clock, but you know, he's a 400 runner, runs 45. And so I just said, let me get out with him and then try to hold on for dear life and see what happens. This season being my last indoor season was really good. I enjoyed the season. Regardless of the outcome, I actually was really happy with the way I was competing all year. It was very consistent, which meant it was showing me that regardless of what happened in that one race in the 60, that I'm prepared for something a lot greater. Even though it's my last indoor season collegiately, it's not going to be my last indoor season ever. And so I'm just gonna carry the experience I've had the last couple of years and use that in my professional career.